Eddie, Jacob, you guys are band leaders, worship leaders, but you're also pastors in our church. And when we recruit people to the weekend worship ministry, we're recruiting musicians to serve. But how can we serve them as they serve others? How can we give them a foundation not to just feel like they're just playing musical instruments,
right,
but they're actually serving our congregations?
I think of all the bands that I've led or been a part of, and there's such a tendency to focus on the music because that's what you're there to do, and I get that. And because when we recruit a band of musicians to lead a worship service, we're wondering how good are they, or, you know, what are they good at, what can they bring to the service. What God really put on my heart is to realize that these people are the ministry. You know, we're not just like using them to bless our church. It's about partnering in ministry with them. It's all about a perspective as far as how you view that team. And you have the choice of viewing them only by their skill or viewing them as members of a body. In 1 Corinthians chapter 12, where he's talking about the church and how there's different members and we all do different things, but we're all united by the same Spirit. It's the same God, same Lord. And so I've been really blessed by this passage because I think of a band when I see this picture. So I think of the fact that, one, you know, 1 Corinthians chapter 12, it says, to each is given the manifestation of the Spirit for the common good. So when I look at a band and when I'm recruiting and when I'm dealing with them, I'm always saying, hey, what we're here to do is to bless the church. So we start with that. We start with knowing that our gifts are for the common good. And I know a lot of people say, well, if you're talking about musical gifts, are we really talking about what this passage says? Because they think it's only spiritual gifts. But I think Scripture is very clear. It's not just your gifts, but it also says that there's a variety of services and a variety of activities. So it's all funneled through the fact that it comes from God. And the second thing that I pull from this passage is that it says that, but as it is, God arranged the members in the body. And that is such a key point for every single musician, because so much of the internal frustration that a musician can have is the fact that I don't have the position that I think I deserve or that I want to be in. And I've been working and I've been practicing in my room, but I still am not getting the opportunities that I want. And there's just such a great thing that happens when everyone just understands, hey, God arranged it this way. In verse 25, when it says that there may be no division in the body. Like, clearly, when that's your foundation and you see that it's all funneled through what God has arranged, that's the key towards having that band on stage. Because there's a big difference between the band on stage and just playing the songs. Mm-hmm. And the band on stage, it's like, we're in this together, we're each doing our part, and we're all going towards the same thing.
Right.
And I think anything I can do as a band leader to bring us back to those principles, like, that's what I'm there to do, and to remind us of that. And every time I have a conversation with a drummer, hey, you know, you did this time, and where did that come from? And it's kind of like, at the end of the day, the answer is like, I'm just bored. You know, I wanted to do this. And if that's the answer, well, then I have to come back to these principles, because I'm not trying to teach them, hey, this is how I work. No, but this is what the Lord is doing in that, and for the common good. And what you're doing is actually getting in the way of what we're trying to do for the church.